Welcome back to Necopara.
Oh boy.
Hi, Suki.
Asunion, it's almost like Master is your master, isn't it?
Don't get back in this bullshit again.
Oh god. Azuki maiden, you look like a maiden cat girl.
Yo, shut up! I'm seriously not some love-stricken maiden. Coconut's the one getting all lovey-dovey over Cashew, seriously. Quit making stuff up, seriously, like for real.
For real, uh-huh.
Why, my master is Shigure-chan, but Oni-chan is like my master, right?
Yeah, Coco-chan is falling in love with Master too, Mio.
Yep. Master really is a pervy pastry puffer.
Oh, we've gone from horny to pervy. That's a great way.
A real
dick.
Predator. He'll go after any cat girl he lays his eyes on.
I indented myself as an attack helicopter. Stop saying things like that. You'll give people the wrong idea. I pinch Vanilla's cheek. She puffs them out.
But chocolate bets, it would be fun if everyone became Master's companions, meow.
What?
You said that's... no.
That might not be such a bad idea.
It's a terrible fucking idea.
Well, yo, why? You're not helping me bake a cake as an excuse to get together with me, are ya?
Read the line. Focus, Raw!
Oni-chan is already companions with Chocolate and Vanilla?
Oh god, they didn't know. Holy shit.
Yeah, I ain't so desperate that I'd steal my little sister's man.
Oh my god, she is pissed.
Cut it out, guys. Totally cut it out. This discussion is over! The foot has been put down. Come on now.
But Chocolate's not saying anything weird, is she?
Like, always.
We cat girls are sincere beings, but our love is quite a whimsical thing.
Yeah, we wouldn't want you together some strange cat girl off the streets, but if it's our sisters, then it's totally fine.
What about milk?
The person I love, the sisters I love, equals lots and lots of love, Mia.
What?
Chocolate tried to do mass.
Dear God, no.
The person I love multiplied by the sisters I love. Lots of love. Oh my God.
Master is starting a harem. Maximum yes. Per Fletcher, cat womanizer.
Harem, yes. Awesome. All right. Calm down. Pit. Oh yeah, going for the full harem here. Jeez, what in the world are you two saying? Coconut, Zuki, say something, you're the older sisters.
Yo, yeah, we're the older cat sisters. Come on, Nuts, give them a lecture as an older sister.
What? Why me? You're older than me, Oni-chan.
So, Coco-chan and Asunion don't want to get all lovey-dovey with Master, that Mew?
Oh my god.
Wow.
This is... I don't know where this is going now.
Oh... Well, it's not like I'm totally against it, but...
You guys aren't very convincing. Though I'm not even sure how I respond to that question myself. Azuki and Koga are both adorable. Each one has their own charms, but blah 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 blah. Is that even a word? I'm squinting at it. What the fuck?
No, Chocolate knew it. Knew it.
Shut up.
Hey, Master, did you hear?
Cat girls with polygamy as long as you love us all equally. What?
Cool! Oh my god.
Fuck are we playing?
Yo, this is all wrong. I keep telling you, you got it all wrong.
This is the best part of the game so far. Game.
Anyway, you're totally wrong.
Oh my gosh.
No matter what you say, your tail is showing how you really feel, meow.
Zoom into fucking Chocolate's face.
Yeah, tail.
Yeah. My tail is broken.
Yo, my tail's wrong too. Totally wrong. I tell you, this is all totally screwed up.
Coconut, is your heart throbbing? It is, isn't it?
Well, don't touch my chest. I'm not cinnamon, you know.
What?
No.
What? Not bad, not bad, nothing special, but since chocolates and mine are so modest, we might be a little jealous.
Oh, boy.
Arr, hey, don't grab on so tight. Vanilla, meow.
I'm just watching this from afar. It's like, yeah. Yep. I saw this coming. Yep. I'm prepared.
He wanted us to do another part.
I guess we're done for the day. There's nothing I can do to stop them now. I put the sponge cake batter Zuki and I have made into the refrigerator. We're going to start getting busy and busy. Get back to work. That's about the best I can do. I just surrender myself to the current. The currents.
Yep. Oh boy.
Amazing, they're extra fluffy. They are certainly marketable! We can make money off this shit.
Fuck yeah, cocoa tits.
It's night time.
Uh-oh.
Oh, master, will you really buy chocolate anything she'd like?
No. Yeah, bell renewals and shit. Why don't you, Vanilla, go both pick out whatever you want?
That's a bad idea.
Yay, a present from Master! Hooray!
Hooray!
That's our Master. Always so suave.
Suave.
It's not hard for me to choose what I want, though.
Vanilla, are you ready?
Where the fuck is this guy?
Completely. Everything from tea to potato chips. What? This will keep us alive and fighting for a long time.
Okay.
Alrighty then, let's go!
Are you ready, Raw?
Yep.
Here we go. Aw.
Going shopping!
This is like some meta shit now. And they're playing like human power or something.
Cashew's wallet is fucked, dude. Online shopping together with Chocola. I'm so excited.
Let's kick things off by browsing Amazon.
Oh, that's great. Amazon.
I love Amazon.
Amazon.
Oh, we're getting recommendations based on Master's previous purchases. It's all stuff for the shop. How boring. I was really hoping we'd find something a little more embarrassing.
Come on, that's not what we're here for today. Now, what should we search first? Jewels.
Bejeweled.
But Chocola, you can't tell the difference between a marble and a pearl.
Because you're an idiot.
It's all good as long as it's pretty. Even better if it gets Chocola showered in love.
Chocola, you poor thing. You're such a simple cat girl, aren't you? But that's what makes you cute, so I can't complain.
This! Take a look at this, Vanilla. Oh my gosh! Tuna! They have tuna! Whole tunas at that!
Oh my god. Whoa, a whole tuna for 1,720,000 1,000 yen. Splendid, simply splendid, Chocola.
What? I know tunas can be expensive, but I don't know of a universe where a tuna costs nearly 20,000 US dollars.
It must be some tuna, dude.
It must be some tuna.
Let's see how many hits we get in Google for Otoro tuna. Bet there's more than we can eat.
There you go. Google product placement right there.
Okay, let's bookmark this. We'll make a list and compare them.
She's surprisingly inept with a computer. Adept? Yeah. Adept?
Adept. Adept is what you want.
Yeah.
Enough is
the opposite.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I said you could get whatever you want, but that's just a little too expensive, don't you think? Seriously, do not order that. I'll never forgive you. I'll give you those merciless cat girls a warning. But they never dare order that, right? What'd you say, Master? Yeah.
If they're celebrating now, but it was certainly a trying experience, and they only passed the test by a hair's breadth, sheesh. Vanilla managed without breaking a sweat, but Chocola was completely the opposite. If they ever acted like proper bell-carrying cats, I would indeed buy them a whole tuna.
I see. A whole tuna, huh? My little sister must have several times more wealth than my store does. Where is she getting all this money from?
Cat pornography.
The plot thickens. When did this younger sister of mine get so scary? Like, about 30 episodes ago?
Oh, but if we were to do that, we'd have to buy a refrigerator that can hold a tuna. What? If you'd like me, Sama, I could buy you one.
Where is she getting all this money from? What the fuck?
I don't know.
We'll save that for next time.
Very well. I suppose I should try not to spoil you too much.
What the fuck? Is she like in the mafia or something? I suddenly feel like your little plaything. I wouldn't know what I'd do with such a big refrigerator if she did up buying me one. Though it's scary to think she might actually buy it for me if I ask.
Oh, by the way.
Give me your little sister her sweet farewells or whatever the fuck it is.
It seems like Azuki and Coconut have gotten even more attached to you during the time I was gone. Uh-oh. It seems you've got an affinity for more than just chocolate and vanilla, surely.
I understand what you mean when you said that cat girls are always growing. I feel sugar and what happened while she was gone.
You're a real cat girl killer, Niisama. No, maybe lady killer is more accurate. I know you must be proud of that, but as a woman, no, as your little sister, it worries me.
What the hell do you mean by lady killer?
Well, the fact that you don't think that way is also part of your charm. I suppose I can't always have my way.
God damn it. She smiles knowingly if she lifts up her teacup to her mouth. I'm just doing what any family member would do. No one's going to criticize me for that. As I ponder that thought, I take a sip from my own teacup and smelt the drugs in it.
By the way, I've been meaning to ask, but aren't you worried about the fact that cat girls are polygamous creatures?
Not at all. Yep. Not at all.
There will be jealousy, of course, but unlike humans, cat girls don't feel the need to keep their mates to themselves. I know that I don't have to worry about you, Niisama. I'm sure you won't be walking down the aisle with any of them, right? Oh god. Wouldn't it be wonderful if Azuki and Coconut longed to be your brides as well? The fact that the daughters I've raised so well have fallen head over heels in love with you makes me happy beyond words, Niisama.
No!
Scary.
No!
It's all her plan.
I thought her plan was us. But anyways, until recently I considered myself business partners with the cat girls. But after getting romantically involved with Chocolate Villa, which will we never discuss again, I don't know what to say anymore.
Nisama's anguished expression so arouses my spirits as a little sister. Please forgive your sinful little sister who gets such joy out of tormenting her beloved brother. Ha ha ha.
I still don't know what to say to her, and I turn my head away in embarrassment. Meanwhile, back at the plot...
If one whole tuna is too expensive, a whole Matsuzaka cow is definitely out of the question.
Matsuzaka. Matsuzaka.
Matsuzaka. A Matsuzaka cow seems to cost around 5 million yen. I don't think we have enough, Meow.
What? $55,000 for a cow does seem pretty excessive.
This is our weakness, as we are but cat girls who have fallen in love with an unresourceful master. What can we do?
Oh, fuck you. I'm serious now. If you buy that, we'll go bankrupt. I'll give another strong warning to my two misses of cat girls. Oh, I feel like this is just an exercise in futility. Flutivity.
Now then, I shall be taking my leave.
Good. See ya.
Oh no, having the privilege of helping her older brother is a younger sister's greatest joy.
No, it is not.
In any case, there is a taxi waiting for me outside.
Maybe the taxi driver gives her all the money. Text me when you make it home, even if you take a taxi home. I worry.
Teehee, Nisama, you're always so smooth. If only I wasn't your little sister.
It's a good thing you are. What do you mean?
Nothing.
Fuck you.
Now, if you'll excuse me. I love you, Nisama. Have a good night.
I'm not trying to be cool as I grumble. Sugar, taxis pull outside. Blah, 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 blah. Well, at least we got rid of her.
Are Coconut and Azuka here? I guess not.
10 pizzas? Come on. Who wouldn't want 10 pizzas?
It's great. Delicious.
You know what you know what we could order with all that money?
What?
A new fucking chair for you. Stop it.
Oni-chan, look. I found something else I can do. I did up a receipt for an online order perfectly. I did a good job, didn't I?
Praise me. Oh yeah, good job. You really give it all, aren't you? Eye patch. Coconut. He's got a pleased look on her face.
Chocolate taught me how to do it.
Is that a good thing?
Meow. Being petted by Oni-chan feels so good.
She rubs her cheek across my chest. Okay. I guess the cat girl's a cat girl, even though she's huge. I like chocolate and vanilla. She has a very womanly figure.
Don't tell them.
She's
that.
Got really ample and a shapely. I started really seeing more of her as a and she's quiet. Wait. No. Stop it. She's just a kitten. She's underage. This is totally not legal. Sugar must have been trying to put you in that direction yesterday, but that doesn't mean you should start looking at her like that, Cashew. I scold myself internally.
Oni-chan, what's wrong?
I'm scolding myself internally.
You just looked really troubled for some reason. Do you not like this? Do you want me to stop?
She looks at me with eyes full of concern. Her face is so innocent. Guilt betrays a tear at my heart. These wounds not heal, etc. I take a deep breath and try to hide what I'm thinking from Coco, and gently stroke her once more. There's no way I'd hate it when you're playful, you know. It's cute, but I was just a little embarrassed.
Embarrassed? You're just like always, though. Teehee, my Oni-chan sure is silly.
She rubs her whole body against me with even a hint of shame. This is just a cat girl's display affection, right? Right. It's how a cat girl shows her love. It's just how she shows her love. It's just. She's soft and supple. No matter where I touch. I try to drive my pure thoughts by cautioning myself over and over and over again. Like I'm chanting a spell.
Uh-oh.
Hey!
Coco-chan is snuggling up with Master. Master, chocolate too. Chocolate wants to be petted too. Pet us both.
Oh, she wants a pet.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, sure. Come on in.
Okay, let's let Chocolate join in.
Yay, I love you too, Coco-chan.
This is fucked up, dude.
Hey, don't just fault me to pet you both. Coconut and chocolate, coil around me. I hope I don't have to read that line again later on.
Aw, what's wrong, Chocola?
What do you think's wrong, Raw?
We're not having sexy times.
No. Are you serious? What do you think's wrong with...
I seriously think that's what's up.
What do you think's wrong with...
I don't know.
You don't know? Come on, Raw.
Jealousy?
It's painfully obvious at this point.
Jealousy?
No. It's a much shorter word and it begins with H.
Heat?
Good job.
Uh-oh. Coconut, is it okay if Chocolate just...
Chocolate detangles herself from me and latches onto Coconut.
What?
Oh boy. She squeezes Coconut several times. I like where this is going. Although it's... Though she's not quite sure what she's feeling.
What's wrong, Chocola? Is there something wrong with me?
Is there?
Coco-chan, your boobies are so cushiony, so flubby-wubby.
Flubby-wubby. Flubby-wubby.
That doesn't seem like a problem, but sure.
Wow, this is crazy. They feel so squishy, meow.
I'm gonna laugh if Coconut doesn't even know what the boobs are. Are they?
Vanillas have a totally different feel to them.
I hope Vanilla isn't listening on this.
Right here, they're super duper soft right here.
Thanks, I guess.
Coconut watches in amazement, as do I, as Chocolate bounces around in excitement, but gets more and more worn out with each hug. Well, it's not like I was thinking about their differences a minute ago. I guess I can understand how Chocolate feels.
Master's starting to get a pervy look on his face. He can't help it.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
What? A pervy look?
Yep, a pervy look. Master got all excited when he was petting you.
Mm-hmm.
Excited? What do you mean? Oh my god.
She looks at me with a wise own and her face turns bright red. What will save us from this predicament, Raw?
End the episode now.